Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, bonitas, bonitos, muchachos, muchachas. Welcome to the Musical King Radio Show, where every Thursday I bring you one song. One big tune. Tony Montana Jacuzzi. Monica Pamela Susie. Mandem. Right on the beat, so cozy. West End to the East End, all the GLM, no, I'm bossy. We don't care where that. Get a ticket for the. After party was in. Came up drinking. Vodka with that bokeh, I know Pookie and Pookie. Goku and Goki. International, my. Remy Govi. Me, you, and your friends. Me, you, and your friends. We could be gone with the wind. Welcome to the Musical King Radio Show. We are truly ASEM. Wonderful, gorgeous, beautiful Thursday. How you doing? Life is good. God is good. Pew, 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 pew. Tew, 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 tew. Double silencer, smooth operator, I'm the assembler. Double silencer, smooth operator, I'm the assembler. Batman Vex when I do my thing. Man, I rule a king. This is the Musical King Radio Show. We are truly ASEM. Thank you for tuning in. Another eventful week. This week is packed, full of action and drama. But before we get to that, in case you wanna wear, you're doing the song in the back. Tune in the back, coming from the man, the boy, that make the legend. ASEM, and he calls this song Pew Pew. And if you go on Spotify and you search for ASEM Afro Grooves, you're gonna find this tune together with other special bad bad vibes. Now me, myself, and I curate for your listening pleasure. Tune in the back, Pew Pew from ASEM. Coming off his highly anticipated Weather Channel EP coming soon. Now let's get to the nitty gritties, but before we get to that, I want to definitely say happy birthday to two legendary, iconic civil rights fighters, civil rights movement activists. They changed the world. We're talking about February 23rd, which was Monday, was the birthday of John Lewis. You know who John Lewis is. You've seen the Selma movie. John Lewis, who's in blessed memory. It was his birthday, so raise a glass, raise a toast for John Lewis. And also was the birthday of the greatest iconic entertainer of all time, 21st century. We're talking about Miss Nina Simone. It was also Nina Simone's birthday on February 21st. What are the odds of two iconic civil rights leaders, spearheaders of the 21st century, celebrating the birthday on February 21st? So light a big one, raise a glass, raise a toast to Nina Simone and John Lewis. Now let's get to politics as usual. The conversation all week for the past 2 weeks. But if you want to talk about the past 8 years, it has been about Russia and Ukraine, and the invasion has happened. As we speak right now, Russia has invaded into Ukraine, a full-on attack, land and sea. Okay, now we're talking about this thing that has been happening on the eastern border of Ukraine. Okay, earlier this morning in Ukraine, Russian troops poured over the border. The Russian planes and missiles launchers attacked Ukrainian cities and airports. The attack spanned much of the country, far and beyond the border provinces, where has been sporadic fighting between nations for years. This has been going on for years. This is going to be a long one. Today on the Musical King Radio Show, Russian government called it a full-scale attack from multiple directions. Blasts could be heard in Kyiv, the capital, as well as more than a dozen other cities. At an airport outside Kyiv, rocket attacks targeted parked Ukrainian fighter jets. In a southern part of the city, Odessa, so Russia has attacked from land and sea, a town, a beautiful town in Ukraine. In the southern part called Odessa, Russian troops arrived from sea. In Lutsk, in the northern corner of Ukraine, closer to Poland than Russia, explosions were also reported. So Vladimir Putin, on the other hand, he's calling it. Russian President Vladimir Putin says the invasion is a special military operation rather than a war, and Russia said civilians will not be attacked. But Putin has lied repeatedly in the run-up to the invasion, and it was unclear whether those comments had any meaning. So Vladimir Putin is saying it's a special military operation because from the other side of the spectrum, people have said that there are people in Ukraine who want to secede and join Russia. So Vladimir Putin is going there under the guise of trying to help the people in Ukraine who don't want to be a part of Ukraine. This is messy. It's going on. Let me know what you think about it. But the situation right now with the USA and NATO and Russia and Ukraine. We've talked about it. We said before that Vladimir Putin was just bluffing. He was moving his muscle to see what's going to happen. He bluffed, he snuffed, and he realized that NATO and USA don't have any power to stop him. They are talking about sanctions, but proven in the past, right now as we speak, some Russian banks have been sanctioned. They've been blocked. Okay, we're talking about some Russian oligarchs in Europe whose accounts have been seized, but this looks like a calculated mission. The vision of Vladimir Putin and sanctions would not stop him from doing whatever he's going to do. I think the West has gotten soft and Vladimir Putin has called their bluff. Let me know what you think about it. Now let's talk about more other cheery and more other entertaining factors. We're talking about soccer, we're talking about football, and we're talking about the Champions League. And the Champions League went down yesterday where Manchester United were playing like they were a bunch of babies. They were playing like they don't know what's going on. There was no fully uniformity in the club. Now, Cristiano Ronaldo, I told you, would not be the only person to save Manchester United. They had a 1-1 draw with Atletico Madrid in a game that Atletico Madrid could have won. Ajax also played 2-2 with Benfica. Sebastian Haller got some goals, cut a goal too. Okay, and the days before, PSG beat Real Madrid 1-0. Now today we're talking about Europa Leagues. But the Champions League games are getting heated up. Chelsea also played against Lille where they won 2-0. Romelu Lukaku did not play the game. Conversation is still going on and people are talking about why Lukaku did not play. But Thomas Tuchel is trying to find the right set of players who can work. The modern game today is not just about one player, it's about the whole team. And I think Lukaku should put his boots on, should just dig deep within and find a way to play with the formation of Thomas Tuchel. Today we also have some games in the Europa League. The Europa League games are going on today, and Napoli is playing Barcelona, Rangers is playing Dortmund, Dynamo Zagreb is playing Sevilla, and Real Betis is playing Zenit. Thank you for watching the Musical King Radio Show. Like you already know, we have new music, new ASEM music, pew pew, link in the bio. Magician out now, weather channel coming soon, ASEM, Obedantem. This has been the Musical King Radio Show. Thank you.